everybody. Welcome back to this week's episode of Refined TV. Welcome to episode number 50. Halfway there. We're excited. For the past year, we've been running these episodes on a weekly basis. Thanks for your support. We appreciate it. As usual, we're always open to feedback. The reality is we get very little online for suggestions, but I hear it from people when I'm talking to them at one of my two studios and people that I meet, you know, out and about. So I know what we're doing is making a difference. I appreciate it. We try and have fun with this. And today's topic is no different. So today's topic, as I'm looking to my right, because it's kind of a, we copied this one actually. The title is your partner making you fat? A form of love chub rehab. Okay. For those of you that haven't figured this out, some of these titles we come up with, the reality is, these titles are just, I mean, we have a lot of fun with them, so we get them from all kinds of different sources as well. So, but this is relevant. Hopefully it caught your attention. The reality is, to make fitness part of your lifestyle and to change your health, it makes it a lot easier if your partner is on board with those changes. If you're exercising regularly, trying to make dietary changes, and you come home and your partner has a bag of chips and a massive pop, that makes it difficult, especially if that's happening on a regular basis. If your partner is consistently not cooking, if your partner's a finicky eater, if your partner thinks exercise is ridiculous and isn't for them, there is no question that makes it more difficult, okay? But the reality is, you're not the only one running up against that problem. So how do you address that issue, okay? Well, I'm gonna give you a few suggestions, and none of these are miracle solutions, and some of them will work for you, some of them may not work, and sometimes you've just gotta go at it on your own and try and, you know, separate yourself from your partner when it comes to eating and exercise, okay? So one of the main things that you can do is to just have a conversation with your partner to tell them really how important it is to you that they support you in these changes you're trying to make with your diet and with exercise. You know, and just explain to them the ramifications of them not helping you, how difficult that is to you. Let them know you're human. Let them know that if you see them eating certain foods or not exercising, that's going to make it more difficult. And obviously it's a sensitive topic. Partners oftentimes are the worst ones to convince one another to get started on an exercise program. So tread lightly when you're having that conversation, but just let them know, here's why I need your help. And obviously you would love it if they wanted to jump on board with you. If you're someone that is more fit than them, then just be aware of that, because it may not be realistic. Oftentimes it's not realistic for them to keep up with you or to make all of the changes that you're actually making, okay? Next along the way, just talk to them about how those habits, and the reality is how both of your habits, you know, it's not just about them. If you're wanting to get healthier and be more fit, the reality is you were probably doing some things that weren't super healthy as well. So make sure that they know that. Make sure that you're honest and open with them about the fact that, hey, this is the kind of stuff we're doing and here's why we need to change it. You know, you want to live a long life together, hopefully. The quality of your life, you want to be strong. If you've got examples of people in your life that haven't taken care of them health, haven't taken care of themselves and have health conditions, you know, let's have those discussions. And then hopefully that will get them on board to let them know that, yeah, you know what, this is something I can help you with. Or at least support you on. They may not be willing to get started on exercise program. They may not be willing to cut out the fast food and the junk food, but hopefully they're willing to take some steps by keeping it separate from, you know, a cupboard that you'd normally go into or putting it in another spot. So really having that heart-to-heart discussion with them, but not in a way that talks them down and makes them feel like, you know, they're so unhealthy. We all make mistakes. We've all gone through periods where we're making unhealthy decisions. Okay, try and get them on board. At the end of the day, if they're not on board and they're not going to support you, you know, you've got to do it on your own, and you're not the only person that's ever done it. So show some willpower, show some strength, set some goals. You may find you need to work with a personal trainer to help keep you accountable and keep you on track. A great trainer can definitely replace you know, a partner, and sometimes, quite honestly, even often, I would say most of the time, a personal trainer is going to do a better job than your partner, because, you know, someone that you live with on a regular basis, oftentimes there's going to be some headbutting going on, and that's obviously not what you want to have disagreements about. So that's my suggestion for how to deal with a partner that's making you fat, obviously they're not making you fat. They're just not making it easier for you to get healthier. So have that tough conversation. If it doesn't work for you, talk to a personal trainer. Let them help you stay fit and healthy, and then you do the best you can. Okay? So thanks for checking into episode 50. Always appreciate your support. As always, Mike Bates from Refined TV.